So, Twitch chat, now that other YugiTubers are going on hiatuses, do you guys think that I was right about Summer and Yu-Gi-Oh? I'll show you guys what I mean, by the way. I just saw this like maybe like an hour ago. Let's see. No. Well, hold on. Let me show you first. Quick heads up, everyone. Hold on, I'm gonna pause this for a second. Cause I did notice this. Quick heads up, everyone. We're taking a short hiatus from uploading for a bit. Wanted a break before we jump into the summer. Jump into a summer full of new Yu-Gi-Oh! Videos. What does that mean, by the way? Like, if you're taking a break before summer, does that just mean like a month off or something like that? There's a lot of fun and weird new stuff we're working on for you guys and want to make sure it's the best it can be. Bro, I feel like, man, damn it. Yo, press one if they stole my thunder. I feel like I should have made an announcement just I should have made an announcement just like this. And now if I do it, everyone's going to say that I'm copying Paul and ABS. Oh, snap. This is like the perfect way to do it, by the way. Okay. We'll still be around social media and uploading some things on the second channel, Team APS Plus. Until then, duelists, past turn. Wow. Yeah, I got it. What's it called? Time to join APS now. I should have done that too. I know. I just didn't know what to post. And now I was like, now I know exactly what to post. I can just like copy this. Or what's it called? Press one to just do the same exact thing, except instead of having Yugi, just have Kaiba. Because, I mean, that's all I need, right? Just have Kaiba shuffling his deck into a dual disc. Copy and paste. No, I mean, I don't want to copy the gift. I can copy and paste this, but like, I could have the gift just be Kaiba. Because, I mean, finding Kaiba shuffling his deck into it, like, there's probably 50 of those clips from like the anime. So I definitely can, what's it called? Besides the gif. Yeah, I definitely. Is this it? Is this Kaiba? It's not. Okay.
Music. It's time to fuck Farpa.
Oh, I've seen this before. Okay. But anyways, all I'm saying, chat, is just for those of you, Cat G gets burnt out reading from YG Organization. I'm just saying, like, everybody needs a break, chat. You know what I mean? A break. We all need, like, I can guarantee you guys, a channel like APS, real talk, chat, I can guarantee you, like, a channel like this, making the ideas and stuff that they make, I'm pretty sure that they have brainstorming sessions, chat, where it's probably like five of them, they get together, and they probably just come up with ideas for, like, they probably have brainstorming sessions for, like, hours. You know what I mean? And once they've done them, especially because their videos are scripted and require acting, I guarantee you guys, after like a couple of months of it, they're like, yeah, we need a break. You know what I mean? Like, we need a break. They have to find a Walmart. Yeah, but that's not just all their videos. Hold on. That's not just all their videos, though. Like, all their videos aren't just, you know, we went to Walmart and found packs. It's like, let's see. I want to find just a full. Oh, here we go. Like this.
All right. Get ready to waste all of your free time and spend every penny you've ever made because it's time to duel. Now, did you watch any of those EDO Pro replays I sent you?
I like Larry.
Why the hell not?
It's only about an hour long, but you ain't got nothing else to do. You ain't got a date or nothing.
All right, now watch me and everything.
I feel like when I was in shitty replay phase, that's how people were to me, chat. People send me like 80 replays, be like, bro, why didn't you watch all 78 of them? Why not? You ain't got nothing else to do, Cap. Like, bro, I got.
It's only about an hour long, but you ain't got nothing else to do. Yeah. You ain't got a date
like
or nothing.
Like, right, yeah.
Now watch me. And everything I'd... Long ago, when the pyramids were still young,
the Egyptian pharaohs played a game of great and terrible power.
So there are 10 ways to summon a monster. Sweet. Okay, so you start with 8,000 life points, and if they ever hit zero, you can just give up on life immediately.
Yeah, I'll get to that in a moment. Don't rush me.
Of course, you got your normal, you got your flip, you got a flip that bad boy. Okay, so a game consists of you and your opponent taking turns, with each turn consisting of 6 phases.
This is what I mean, by the way, chat. Like, doing these videos, you guys might cringe at them or just watch them in a couple minutes, but like, doing stuff like this all the time, like, it's mentally taxing, chat. Like, it honestly is. You know what I mean? Quick heads up, everyone. I'm taking a short hiatus from uploading for a bit. I wanted a break since it's summer. Since it's a summer full of bad Yu-Gi-Oh! Videos, there's a lot of fun and weird stuff, new stuff I'm working on for you guys. I want to make sure it's the best it can be. I'll still be on social media and streaming on Twitch at Mega Capital G. Until then, students, pass turn bottle. I like it. Should we just go with this, chat? Should we go with what Super Canadian? Let me think. I mean, I'm not actually on social media. Not for like YouTube. You know what I mean? Like, even if I did use Twitter, chat, like, I would not want someone just being like, hey, Cap, what do you think of new, you know, fucking, like, Cap, what do you think of the new Speedroid dice card that requires you, like, bro, don't, please, no, don't, like, stop.
Jesus. All right, so go
What's
ahead.
Your excuse? What do you mean my excuse? Not my excuse not to post the, with Super Canadian post? Here's a Kaiba gift. It's cool, but it's not exact. It's not like exactly like theirs. I just want Kaiba like loading his deck into a dual disc. I'm pretty sure I can find it. This is just Cap mocking the video. I'm not mocking any videos. What do you mean this? I'm not mocking their video. Like, I'm showing you guys, like, it's hard, man. Like, being a Yu-Gi-Tuber is not hard, chat. Being a great Yu-Gi-Tuber is hard. True or false, chat? I hate Larry Wears Trucks. Dude, Larry's the man. What are you talking about? Chat, true or false? Being a great Yu-Gi-Tuber is hard. It's hard work. True or false? Just a one-word answer, chat. Being a great Yu-Gi-Tuber is hard. Am I a great Yu-Gi-Tuber? I think I'm a great Yu-Gi-Tuber when I want to be. False? I disagree. Name me a great Yu-Gi-Tuber. Name me a great Yu-Gi-Tuber who doesn't put in a lot of work. Like, name me the great Yugi, and by the way, I'm saying great Yugi-Tuber. Ruffington, he's not great. Ruffington's not great. When I say great, I don't mean, great cannot just be measured by success. And also, like, does he even qualify as a Yugi-Tuber anymore? He hasn't uploaded. Wait, Raggington? Ruggington. Like, does he even qualify as a Yugi-Tuber? Sladra?
Take a look.
Also not great. DPYGL, that actually might disprove my argument, to be honest. Because a lot of people would say that DP Yu-Gi-Oh! Is great, but like, pretty sure his videos don't take that much. Gage, all they do is get his ass handed to him. Farfish YouTube, is Selza a great Yu-Gi-Tuber, chat? Really? Simo, Sam... Duologs. I, as much as I trash Duologs, chat, Duologs does put in some. He does put in a good amount of work. Although I think when it comes to structuring his videos, I think his editor does, like, his editor puts the video together. But I'm pretty sure he writes the videos and also chooses the topics. Although I don't think all his topics are great. His Discord does? Really? I can't think of his name. I thought that was Devinator who picked videos from Discords. Here's a shuffling gift for you. Devinator, it's all him. Yeah, but you can't see Kaiba though. You need to see Kaiba. Like, we need to see Kaiba, chat. No, he fucking doesn't. Fine. Are there any great Yu-Gi-Tubers, chat? Are there any great Yu-Gi-Tubers? Jeez, you guys apparently no one. You can see his light skin. Use this one. No. this works. I need it to be bigger. Yeah, this actually works. It just needs to be bigger. Kaiba. Was this you? Atenza? You posted this? Yeah, Atenza, can you make this bigger? If you can make this like a full size, then this definitely works. Chat, so there's no great YugiTubers. The Highlight Channel, rank 10. Oh, that says rank 19 Yu-Gi-Oh, not rank 10. I mean, maybe rank 19 is a great YugiTuber. I have no idea who that is, but maybe they are. I'm not gonna dignify this with a response. When Galactic God quits, they're stopped being a good YugiTuber. I won't speak for every YugiTuber, chat, and I will not sit here and bash my contemporaries. I will, however, defend myself. As I have said before, I believe, and I don't care if you don't like when I compare real life to anime, I believe that I am like the Naruto Shippuden of YugiTubing. I am great when I want to be. There you guys go. Take that for what you will. That's also applicable for Bleach. I am the Bleach or the Naruto Shippuden of YugiTubing. I am great when I want to be, but I don't always want to be great. Because being like, now I kind of understand why anime has fillers. Like, being consistently great is fucking hard, but I'm great when I want to be. Season 2 equals Boruto. Let's hope not. Let's hope not. Right now, my channel is in a filler arc, chat. But there's another good arc coming. At least I think it's good. So hopefully you guys will think it's good. Yeah, I am great when I want to be. Yes, you're Naruto, alright. You're great when you want to be. Problem is, you never want to. I just had a great run. What do you mean? I had a great run. Are we seriously, chat? Are we not gonna acknowledge Cap G's awesome run? Is that what we're doing on this stream again? You toxic Nebas. They have filler arcs to keep up with the manga. Well, also because, I mean, the writers just can't write. Writers just can't write anime 24/7, chat. Like, they need breaks. I've actually heard that being an anime writer is like a horrible and stressful job. I think that might be why the suicide rate is so high. But I don't want to delve into that. The next season is the Kaguya arc. I vaguely remember that name. I mean, that's not Bleach. That's referencing Naruto. Oh, I didn't watch this one. No. The next arc is going to be So you guys know how Shippuden starts with them going to the Saiyan village with Gaara. The next arc is going to be when they get back to the Akatsuki. I guess spoiler alert. You guys know when Shikamaru and Asuma are sent after the two members of the Akatsuki, and it goes like really, really bad. That's gonna be the next arc. Yeah, that's gonna be the next arc of the Capital G show. Here, let me ask you guys a question. I was thinking about making this a surprise, but I'm not sure that I want to commit to it. Someone suggested, chat, like last stream, to do another YugiTubing anime opening as part of like the next season of my channel. And I'm like, I'm actually really considering it. What do you guys think about that? Because I know I said that I'd never do another one after the second one didn't do well. But that was largely because that video got copyrighted. But now I'm not saying I'm going to do it, but I'm actually considering it. And to Big Pimpin's discredit, it's not 800, it's like $500, which, I mean, that used to be a lot of money, but I'm not poor now, so that's not a lot of money. And when you say, it's a waste of $800, first off, I'm not poor like you. Second, the first one, see, you're a fake one, BP, so you don't know this. You do realize the first anime opening has over 100,000 views, sir. $500 you could spend on stocks, probably losing on options, to be honest. But yeah, the first anime opening has like 100,000 views. The second one has like 20,000. But that video also got, if you guys don't know, the second anime opening got copyright striked the first day that I uploaded it, chat. Like, if you, yeah, the first, I think I uploaded it either on my birthday or like the day before my birthday, and it was up for one day, and it got taken down for 3 months, chat. The video got taken out for 3 months. Sorry, I don't remember every still shoot from the first anime. Yeah, well, you should. You definitely should. Worst birthday ever. It was. I mean, I was mauling over it, chat. Yeah, but what was the second one? I did JoJo's Bizarre Adventure. See, most of you guys don't even remember the second one because it got copyright striked within the first 24 hours. The first one never got copyright striked. Who's in it? The better question is who isn't. Like, I have in my anime openings chat, I get basically everyone in it. Like, every major YouTuber you can think of. And I could probably do the same one. Yeah, the first one was Naruto. The second one was JoJo. The third one, what do you guys think it should be if I did it? I mean, it's kind of obvious which anime opening I would do. Why do I keep getting these anime Coomer videos? Every video is just like, I think that's Urza from Fairy Tail and it's just her boobs. Maybe it's not Urza. Coomer alert. I didn't request that video. It's just there. Even got a black kid in the opening. Chat, if in a hypothetical YugiTubing anime opening of Paper Moon, who is Cap G? Tell me, chat. Of all the characters you just saw, who am I? It should be obvious. Who's the black kid? I don't know, Selza. I'm the black kid? Shut the hell up. I'm not the black kid. What? No, I'm not the I think his name is Sid. No, I'm not the oh no, that's not Sid. Sid is the there you go. I'm Arachne. No, it's not because it's a girl, it's just because like it's like the second character you see, the whole moment is just for that one character. It's like the perfect spotlight. It's like the perfect spotlight. And usually shows do that for like the villain. You know what I mean? You're the villain. Someone's gotta be the villain. You know what I mean? Like, I don't know, being the hero is kind of cringe, you know, like that's probably something I would have wanted to do when I was like 14, but like, I'm an adult now. Being bad is cool. That's what you learn when you become older, chat. Like, yeah, being the hero is like cool when you're like a little kid, but then when you become older, it's like, nah, actually being bad is actually cool. It's like why kids don't like wrestling heels, chat. Like, kids never like the bad guys in wrestling. But then when you get older, it's like, no, actually the bad guys are cool. You know what I mean? Like, who likes Thanos? When you go watch, like, Avengers Infinity War, like, none of the little kids like Thanos. They all like Iron Man. But then if you ask any adult, they're like, who is the best character? They're like, yo, Thanos. Thanos was cool. He threw his daughter off a cliff. He beat up the Avengers. Like, Thanos is cool. Yeah, there you go. Who are my two henchmen, chat? So if I'm Arachne, then who are these two guys? Like, is this John Moore? He's got that John Moore smile, chat. Like, he sees money. Simo, me, BP, and Selza. Okay. BP and Selza. Well, there you go. BP and Selza. Who are the only two YugiTubers that still like you? None. So, yeah. I don't really put YugiTubers in context of like my relationship with them, because I have no relationship with pretty much anyone, and they all hate me. So there you guys go. Anyways, that's just an idea, chat. So I'm not saying that I would do that. That I am gonna do the YugiTubing anime opening 3. It's just something that I'm thinking about, because I feel like if I do it, then I have to fully commit to this season 2 being like really good. Like, I have to put out. I have to make sure that at least 5 of my videos are like really fire. You know what I mean? So, because the video, these anime, they take about 3 months to make. So, if I started in June, it could be ready. Well, I haven't even talked to the animator. But assuming the animator, like, can work on it. Yeah, like, he could, well, I think he did the last one in, like, 2.5. So, you know. Oh, shit. It's DB Grindr. Where's Grindr? Are you guys saying use Grindr in the video? Or what? Oh, what's up? What's up, Grindr? How are you? He is here. I put Grindr in the video chat. Yeah. Grindr's big enough as a YugiTuber to be in the video now. I mean, I always mix it up. Like, new YugiTubers, wait, would Farfa and Triff be your henchmen? I mean, maybe. They would be in the video. I always mix it up, chat. Because new YugiTubers emerge, like, relevant new YugiTubers emerge, and, you know, I want to acknowledge that. And then some people wouldn't be in it. Like, I don't know, does Simp and Lucky need to be in a video now? Probably not. But, like, somebody like Grindr probably does need to be in there. You know? Pack. Yeah. Like, Pack, Susu. Those are like, newer YugiTubers from, like, the last couple of years who probably need to be in the videos. Who? Susu? Pack? Yeah, you know those. Put Milano in. Anyways, you guys, put Milano in, put Pack in, put all just the new, what's it called, oppressed Asians. Oh, goodness. I was talking about Simply Unlucky, Washed. I mean, Simply Unlucky's running a business. You know what I mean? He probably doesn't have as much time to make videos as he used to. Get the real Spice who... Wait. Get to the real Spice. Who's going to get left out? That Paper Moon opening chat has like 30 characters in it. I could include basically everyone if I wanted to. Like, that opening specifically has enough characters for like everybody. Put Galactic God as the moon. Aww. We get the big heart here. I am thinking about doing a video on Galactic God chat. If I can get in contact with them, I am thinking of doing a video with Galactic God. What's the name of that video, chat? What is the name of that video? I want to see if anyone can get close to what I'm thinking. Coder L? That is not the name of the video, by the way. G-Hopper is the evil moon, the fallen god. I mean, that's sad. I want this video doesn't need to be sad. That's sad. The god of YugiTubing, the dark side of No. I would never do a dark side of YugiTubing on Galactic God. Father, husband, Galactic God. I don't like to get too personal into someone's life. Although we technically did that with G-Hopper. I mean, we got all up in that dude's life. I consider Galactic God the godfather of YugiTubing. So I was thinking the GOAT. What do you guys think that? I could go with like the greatest of all time or the GOAT. People know what the GOAT means, right? I would hope people know what the GOAT means. No? Eh? What is eh? Galactic God is arguably, I would say objectively, the greatest Yugi, or he's generally acknowledged, chat, as like the greatest YugiTuber of all time. Only sports fans. Okay, well then I guess I could go with the greatest of all time. The story of Galactic God. Or maybe the greatest YugiTuber of all time. The story of Galactic God. Zoomer terms? GOAT's not a Zoomer term. What does it mean to be the GOAT? GOAT. What does GOAT mean? Greatest of all time in their field. GOAT is a Zoomer. Dude, it's not. This is not a Zoomer. What? This is not a Zoomer term, Dolan. The first time that I heard this term, they were talking about a football player named Jerry Rice. GOAT used to be a bad thing. I know what you mean. GOAT it means like to be goated, like scapegoated, which is also technically a Yu-Gi-Oh, technically relates to Yu-Gi-Oh. Jerry Rice kind of did. That was the first time, it was the first time that I ever heard the term the GOAT. It was John Madden talking about Jerry Rice. It was Monday Night Football, and John Madden was, they were commentating on Jerry Rice. So this was a long time ago, chat, because Jerry Rice been retired for a while. Legacy of Galactic God. I don't know. Chat, you guys don't like, you guys seriously don't like the greatest of all time? Here, let's put it on text. Everything looks better on text, chat. Because you can visualize it. I don't know. I thought that was like a slam dunk. But expectedly, I get pushback from my Twitch chat. Let's see. Do. 200. Wayne Gretzky. The opposite of G Hopper. Scroll down a bit. Merriam-Webster editor explains Tom Brady's role in GOATs entering the dictionary. Brady equals GOAT. Congrats, brother. Wait, are you telling me that, like, this is going to be a recognized term in the... Oh, this is from 2018. I think you're better served to say the greatest of all time now. Under where the GOAT come from. You don't need to call me illiterate. GOAT as a word is used in reference to greatest of all time, its origin. Oh, Muhammad Ali. In 1992, Lonnie Ali, Muhammad Ali's wife, incorporated GOAT Inc. This company was used as an umbrella for the former boxer's intellectual properties being used for commercial. Oh, I didn't know that. 1996, referencing Penny Hardaway. I love Penny. I don't know if Penny's the GOAT. Yeah, LL Cool J made a song called GOAT. I'm the GOAT, the greatest of all time. LL, Penny Hardaway is no GOAT. He was the GOAT of the Orlando Magic. Right behind Shaq. Right behind the dude he played with. The story of my real father, Galactic God. The story of the greatest Yu-Gi-Tuber of all time. Here's a question, chat. Is this going to bring in views? Because I kind of question not my actual title. What did you recommend? Oh, you mean the real father? Yeah, I'm not gonna go with that. Is this gonna bring in views, chat? The greatest of all time, Galactic God. I'm just wondering if this title is spicy enough. I know some of the titles that I had in the past, you guys think they're cringe, but I think they're spicy. Did you know Galactic God? Yeah, but the title of the video needs to let you know what the video is about, Atenza. Galactic God was, he was known for Did You Know, but me saying Did You Know Galactic God, like, that doesn't really tell you what you're about to watch. Like, this tells you that this video is a story of the greatest YugiTuber of all time, Galactic God. The bright side of YugiTubing, never in a fucking million years. The godfather of YugiTubing. People stories always does well. All the zoomers are gonna say in the chat that it's cringe. Boomer. Oh my god. Yeah, that's so true. Oh, press one chat if all the Zoomers are gonna, they're gonna click on the video and be like, who is this Boomer? This is cringe. That's exactly what they're gonna do. They're gonna be like, who is this Boomer? He's cringe. Where's Pac? He's the GOAT. The YugiTuber who made life better. Wait, what? Should I quit my job and become a BBW supervisor? Is this like porn? Oh, Bath and Body Works. Okay, never mind. I thought that meant something different. Pac is the GOAT, true. Still deciding whether or not to get Digimon Cyber Sleuth Complete Edition for the Switch, says Rather Guys. Rather Guys, I did actually buy some games recently, like, and when I say recently, chat, I mean over like the last 48 hours. You guys will see those probably on next Thursday's stream. It's extra spicy, chat. Extra spicy flex. Okay, let me see. Godfather of YugiTubing, Galactic God. Brightside. I'd recommend the Bright Side of YugiTubing, Galactic God. Oh, you know what? Hold on. This is a legitimate question. I actually think... I think, ironically, Chat, that's a good title. Because it's a good title that represents the story. However, has that name... I don't want to use the word tainted because that's like kind of toxic. How do I ask this question without being toxic? I don't want to say like... Actually, I'll just say that. Has that name been tainted by Jessup's video? By how much of a fly... Did your Yu-Gi-Oh! channel... And I'm not saying his video wasn't good, because I didn't watch it. But it flopped. Like, that's like the part that's not subjective, right? Like, that's not Cap's opinion. The video did flop. At least if you compare it to my video. My video got like 200K, and I don't know what their video's at. Let's just say 30K, and that's being generous. But I kind of wonder, like, maybe that actually does work. Because I already did a Dark Side, and that video did super well. So maybe I can do the Bright Side of YugiTubing Galactic God. Because obviously his video, like, represent, like, the title represents him perfectly. Like, he was, it's at 23. Chat, do you guys think that's a good idea? Like, low-key, I at first kind of laughed because I associated with Jessup's video. But now I'm thinking about it, and I'm like, that might actually work. There's a reason why top 10 worst lists do better than top 10 best. Don't necessarily advertise as wholesome, but as him being high quality. Not sure 100%. Well, what do you guys think? I really want to know you guys' opinions on this. Did you know Galactic God, the legendary YugiTuber? That's not bad. Meh, sure, question. No, I don't want meh, though. Like, if your reaction is meh to a title, that's not good. I don't want people... Your first reaction to a title should not be meh. You know what I mean? Although, I don't know. What do you guys think... Grade the Razor's Edge, chat. Grade that. What is the Razor's Edge? Is that a meh to you? If I told you guys, I don't think I consulted with you guys for that title, right? With the Razor's Edge. I think I just picked that one. Like, if I told you guys, like, oh, I'm going to name this video about Womack's deck, I'm going to name it the Razor's Edge. Cringe? See? Yeah, I feel like you guys would have been like, yo, that title sucks. It's cringe. It's meh. But that video popped off too. I still don't know what it means. It's a wrestling move, and it's an album by AC/DC. Actually, hold on. I was listening to this song the other day. Like, tell me for the love of goodness, you Zoomers know, like, at least this song. Maybe you don't even know who the band is, but just I know you guys have like. Wow, perfect timing, by the way. Perfect timing.
Normies don't want to hear about the brightest or the nicest. They want to either hear about the greatest to ever do it or dark side for some real fucked up shit. So emo, stick with either the greatest or GOAT.
Thank you very much, Big Pimpin'. Normies don't want to hear about the brightest or the nicest. They want to hear about the greatest to ever do it or dark side for some fucked... Oh, why are you trying to make her curse? Some messed up stuff. So in my opinion, stick with either greatest or GOAT. I guess, that's probably one of the reasons that Most Wanted popped off so hard is Most Wanted is about a cheater. And I've said that for a long time, chat. Like, people like toxicity. And you guys can say, cap G, FD positive, and blah, 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 blah. But, like, the honest to God truth is, chat, people like drama, people like toxicity, people like bad. That's the honest to God truth. Like, Most Wanted popped off because it was about a cheater. It was about somebody, he's a bad guy, he's a cheater. You know what I mean? If I did, this is the most wholesome duelist of all time, like, no one would watch that shit. You know what I mean? I do the biggest cheater in Yu-Gi-Oh! History, 500,000 views. But hold on. We starting Thunderstruck over. That's actually a good suggestion. Put Thunderstruck in JoJo. I don't know. JoJo Part 6. I don't know what the girl's powers are. But if they're electricity, dude, yeah. Put Thunderstruck in JoJo. Anyways, the reason that I played this song, chat, is because this song is on the album The Razor's Edge. So, like, The Razor's Edge, the title of the Womack video, it's an ADDC album, and that album has this song on it. So that's how everything kind of ties into what we were talking about. Anyways, back to this. Name the title, Galactic God, exposed, but exposed in a good way. Delinquent duo almost at 1 million. Can I kick it? Seriously? Can I kick it? Wow. Chat, I really don't do this, by the way, chat. Like, if any of you guys think that I look up my videos on, like, a day-to-day or even a week, like, I really don't. Like, I do not look at these videos, chat. I watched Child's Play, like, a couple of weeks ago. Just, like, I was just watching it to watch the video. But I really don't, chat. I really don't go to my videos and, like, look at the views or anything like that. You know what I mean? So, like, this is just, as a side note, this is just what I mean when I say, like, I am great when I want to be. Cap G is the Naruto Shippuden. Whatever your favorite arc is in Naruto Shippuden, that's what this run was. I am great when I want to be. But I don't always want to be great because it's hard work. But when I want to be, this is what, you know, we can produce on this channel. Child's Play is at 300,000. I knew this video was going to blow up. This video was going to blow up just because of the thumbnail alone. Like, the intrigue of an 11-year-old winning a Yu-Gi-Oh! Championship was something that was going to draw people to this video. Like, I knew that when I first hit Austin up. I was like, this video is going to be big. The only reservation that I had for Child's Play was how much information I could get out of Austin. Like, that was the only, what's it called, reservation. Was like, could I get him to work on the video with me? But like, once I got him on board, I was like, this shit's gonna blow up. You know what I mean? Like, I knew that. You're Zuko? I guess that works. What if G-Hopper comes out, finds your video, and sends a bounty on you? Also, when does G-Hopper get out of prison? Also, do the dark side on Chato chat. I mean, why would you want to do that though, right? Chat, isn't prison supposed to be to reform you? And I know I say I'm putting in quotes because, like, I don't know. You guys can call me a villain. I don't really know that, like, I guess I'll just say it. I don't really think it works. Like, I don't really think prison... People say, like, oh, prison isn't for reforming in the U.S., it's for money. I just don't think reforming works. Like, bro, if you're, like, a child molester, there's no amount of reforming we can do. Like, you're just gonna be terrible. Unless it's, like, a white-collar crime, like, you tax evaded or some shit. Like, all right, we can reform that, I guess. But if you're an actual murderer, we can't reform that shit out of you. You know what I mean? Like, you can't be, Firefox can't be, that's just my opinion, chat. I believe that some people are in prison, some people in prison are so heinous, like, they can't be reformed. You know what I mean? And I don't even want to try to reform them. Hey, it's BP, chat, playing Phantom Knights. Wait, how did we even get on prison, by the way? Will the Yu-Gi-Oh! Hustler be... That is... Yo, Selza, I think that video could be... Hold on, do I have that on my... What's it called? Let's see. Stevie B, Chateau Chat. I think this video has... Maybe this might be it. I think this video has so much potential, Selza. So, chat, as you guys can see, I have so much... I have, like, a collection of stuff about the Yu-Gi-Oh! Hustler, the guy Ramesh. The only thing is, I know I won't be able to contact Ramesh, but Jessif is your Yu-Gi-Oh! So I have more than enough clips to like make a video on this guy. Jessif is your Yu-Gi-Oh! Channel. This is him.
It's been years.
The only thing is, I kind of need Jessif to like. Here, I gotta turn the volume down. I think this video has so much potential, right? I think the video has so much potential. I just think to like fully realize that potential, right? For me making the video, I think that I would need Jessif's help. And I don't know if he's gonna work with me, chat. Do you guys think that he would? Cause like, I'm pretty sure Jessif has seen, he's seen the dark side of Yugi-tubing, and Jessif's like a nice guy. So he might be like, Cap, I'm not gonna let you, you know, drag Ramesh through the mud. Like, maybe, yeah, I'm thinking, like, I don't know. I don't, like, it's definitely not, like, a yes. I don't know if it's a no, but it's like, a maybe at best. He doesn't like you, right? I don't know. I've never actually interacted with him ever. So, like, I don't know why he would even, like, not like me. I've never even really talked about him. Not in a video. But, like, chat, I think that video about the Yu-Gi-Oh! Hustler... Like, I think this video could blow up. Now, are the fight scenes going to be included? Why wouldn't they be? It's part of, like, anything that's part of the story is going to be in the video, chat. Like, so if you're asking me, like, is the fight going to be like, are the fights going to be in the video? Yeah, because it's part of this, it's part of the story. You know what I mean? The hood side of Yugi-tubing. Like, yeah, it's part of the story. So, yes, the fight scenes would be in the video. You know what I mean? I just, like, why are you making a video on him? Because it's interesting. It's honestly just that. It's interesting. And it's Yu-Gi-Oh! The darker side. The darkest side of Yugi-tubing. What do I think of Millennium Ultra Rare? It looks kind of cool. Wish the TCG would input it from the OCG. Says Lord Red, like, give me an example. Show me like a Millennium Ultra Rare card so I can know what you're talking about. Just being a jerk. I mean, it's interesting. Chat, my for anyone thinking like, oh Cap, why are you making a video on, why make a video about anything? Why make a video about Roy? Like, I'm pretty sure there are gonna be people who are like, Cap, why are you making a video about Roy St. Clair? He's dead. Don't make a video about him. It's inappropriate. Like, why make a video about anything, chat? Like, I want to educate and entertain. It's really just that simple. Educate and entertain. Those are the two things that I want to do, chat. Educate and entertain. If I can do one of those things, then it's appropriate. You know what I mean? Like, why make a video about G-Hopper? And also make money, yes. I do want to also make money. Yeah, that is part of it. If someone was like, oh, Cap, would you Yugi-tube for free? Like, I used to. Like, we all do our hobbies for free at one point, chat. But then if you're really, 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 really good at it, you can make money off of it. So, yeah. Cat, why are you making a video? Exactly. Like, I want to educate, entertain, and make money. So, is anything... What's wrong with that, chat? What's wrong with wanting to educate, entertain, and make money?